Researchers in the U.S. now say they found cases of whooping cough that may be resistant to the vaccine. The Centers for Disease Control is reluctant to draw conclusions from the study, but vaccine resistance could be one reason why cases of whooping cough have been increasing. Our KPBS and iNews Source Investigations desk began looking into the whooping cough vaccine more than 2 years ago. Investigations producer Joanne Farian has more.
It was late summer 2010. San Diego County was experiencing what would become the worst whooping cough epidemic in decades. KPBS and iNews Source learned the vaccine was failing at an unexpected rate. Here's an excerpt from our 2010 documentary, When Immunity Fails, the Whooping Cough Epidemic.
Just how did Matthew and so many others come down with a disease that is supposed to be preventable with a vaccine? Tonight, we'll raise questions about the effectiveness of that vaccine. A four-month investigation by KPBS and the Watchdog Institute found many people who had been diagnosed with whooping cough were already immunized.
Joining me to talk about new research suggesting a new strain of whooping cough may be contributing to the increasing number of cases is Dr. Mark Sawyer. He is a professor of clinical pediatric infectious diseases at the UCSD School of Medicine and Rady's Children's Hospital. Doctor, thank you for being here.
Thank you.
So we didn't hear a lot about whooping cough until recent years, really. First of all, tell us, remind us what this disease is all about.
Well, your grandparents know all about whooping cough because back in the 40s and 50s, every child had it. And it's a respiratory infection which leads to a very protracted and difficult cough, which often ends with a whoop, and that's where the name comes from.
Now, we do have a vaccine that's available, and most kids get immunized. What is the new research suggesting with regard to why this vaccine may be losing some of its punch?
Well, starting with the California outbreak in 2010, we recognized that more and more people were getting the whooping cough even when vaccinated, as you pointed out. And as we've learned more about that in the coming years, I think it's become clear that that's because we've switched vaccines in the 1990s and 2000s to a different type of vaccine, and it's not working as well.
Now, in our investigation back in 2010, we also traveled to the Netherlands, where we met with the government scientist. His name is Dr. Fritz Mooy, and he had been publishing reports since 1998 that suggested perhaps the strain is changing, the strain of whooping cough, and that was leading to increased vaccine failure. And again, he'd been doing this since 1998. I know other countries have also made note of this changing strain. Why do you think the U.S. has been slower to talk about this or even to make this discovery?
Well, I know the CDC investigators were aware of his work and the changing strain, and they went back and looked at strains causing outbreaks in the mid-2000s in the United States, and they were not due to those strains. Now, whether the more recent outbreaks are due to changes, I don't think we even know yet.
And what's happening with regard to developing a new vaccine?
Well, I think the signal's been sent that we need a new vaccine, starting in 2010 with the increased cases, which have continued around the United States. There have been a number of outbreaks since then. So I think we know now that we need a new vaccine, that the one we switched to, although it had fewer side effects, which is the reason we changed to it, it's not working well enough. So the companies know that we need a new vaccine, and the scientists know that as well.
Now, this could potentially take years. I know you're also on the Centers for Disease Control's Advisory Committee on Immunization Practices. How is that committee addressing this issue now?
Well, that committee can only make recommendations on vaccines we have now. So we're making recommendations. We're looking particularly at whether adults need a booster dose of the vaccine that some have now received for one time only. And you're likely to see a recommendation for that in the very short term. But until we get a new vaccine, that committee can't really act and make brand new recommendations until we know more about what's coming.
Okay, Dr. Mark Sawyer, thanks so much for being here.
Thank you.